I met him in either late 1975 or early 76, and I'd been working in a gallery. He had a fabulous project where he would dig down and come up in the floor of the building next door, which unfortunately happened to be the Chase Manhattan Bank, and we realized, well, that was never going to work, but Gordon and I worked out just fine. He went into the gallery one day and said, "I need a house." So Gordon went in and he cut the house in half. He had lowered the foundation of the house to create a wedge of light. These cuttings were removed as a kind of a memory of the piece. Gordon had an image of himself as the alchemist, someone who could transform the garbage of the city into something else. The Pier 52 piece on the Hudson, which he called Day's End, is an example. However, the New York City officials didn't appreciate it as much, and they issued a warrant for his arrest. Gordon was a fugitive when he did this exhibition in Paris, and what Gordon did was to carve out a cone that goes up at a 32 degree angle, and it offers you a view from old Paris into new Paris. This was a series he made in Queens called The Fake Estates. He discovered these little slivers of property, such as this little one here, which is 2 feet by 2 feet, is completely landlocked. This is a property that's about a foot wide. He owned 15 estates in Queens. Gordon had gone to Cornell University and had gotten a degree in architecture. I think he horrified a number of his professors later on. There's a wonderful piece called Window Blowout. Whomever had invited Gordon to participate in this exhibition obviously was unfamiliar with his work. The exhibition was models of these exquisite houses. And Gordon went up to the South Bronx, and he saw how contemporary architecture had really failed this particular area. So he photographed these. Gordon installed them at the exhibition and proceeded to use an air gun to blow out all of the windows in the room. He changed the context to be that of the South Bronx. And no one was quite sure if what he was doing was art or was it vandalism. This is Gordon's last building project. It was done in Chicago in 1978, and it's called Circus or Caribbean Orange. You get a real sense of vertigo in them, not knowing what floor you're looking at. This is one floor, and then this is actually the floor above. He began to feel ill during that week. Gordon died of pancreatic cancer in August of 1978, and this building was still standing when he died. So I had asked a number of my artist friends if they would help me try to save the building, and we had hundreds and hundreds of artworks offered to the country of Belgium if they would save this building. The building owner decided instead to tear the building down, and we lost one of the last buildings that he had actually cut. Now none of the buildings exist. When Gordon died, he didn't feel he had made enough work that it could be properly appreciated. I think his reputation today is really due to the support of his friends. He didn't know if anyone would remember his work a year after he died. He had no expectations when he died. So for me, it's really gratifying.